maybe about a week or so ago, Malleable posted a giant blog post, "Don't support the Core Boot Project." Now, it was not my plan at the time, but the video on that did turn out to be about 40 minutes long. So, yeah, I understand why you may not have watched the entire thing. If you didn't see the video and you don't know what the topic's about whatsoever, I don't know why you're here watching a response video, but regardless, what it was is Malleable is this small laptop seller, and they wanted to go and core boot some of their laptops. So they went to a bunch of consultants, and the consultants didn't agree with Malleable on how much work had to be done, and Malleable's response was basically, "We're gonna ban a bunch of countries from buying our laptops from a company that you probably have never heard of, so it probably didn't affect you." But as you probably worked out from the title, now there has been some official responses from both the Core Boot Project and Nine Elements, one of the consultants mentioned in the Malleable blog post. In fact, it is the first one they mention. Now, both of these posts are self-contained, but they do reference each other at the end and link back and forth. So I could realistically start with either of them, but the Core Boot one is kind of funnier, so I'm gonna save that till the end. Response to recent Malleable blog post regarding Nine Elements, written by Christian Walter of Nine Elements. "We have recently become aware of a blog post published by Malleable. This is marketing speak for, we've known about it since the day it came out, detailing their experience working with Nine Elements and other companies on a Core Boot related project. We take all client feedback seriously and wish to address some of the claims made in this post." The reason we're starting with this one is, this one is a lot more cordial and business-like, so it's a good entry point. "To clarify the timeline and nature of our engagement with Malleable, in May 2023, Malleable approached us for Core Boot firmware development, but ultimately decided to proceed with a freelance engineer due to budget constraints. This is when they initially decided that they were going to try and port Core Boot to their laptops themselves, and then they realized that, it's like one dude that runs the company, realized that he didn't actually know what he was doing, and going to the consultants probably was a good idea. In March of 2024, they returned to us with an urgent request to develop Core Boot and EDK2 firmware along with an embedded controller firmware under a tight timeline. While no formal contract was in place, we initiated work in good faith, aiming to provide flexible payment and project scope solutions to fit their budget." Now, this part right here is very, very important. No formal contract was in place. Keep that in mind. "Throughout the engagement, we encountered communication challenges, including frequent status update requests and a misalignment between expectations and technical realities. Again, no contract had been signed." This was during the stage of evaluation, basically. "The initial firmware required considerable work before it could be tested on hardware, which understandably caused some delays. What they were provided was a clone of the System 76 Core Boot Tree, which works on the System 76 hardware, but didn't work on the hardware that they had been provided to do the porting work for, because if it just worked, they wouldn't need to do any porting work here. Unfortunately, during this period, the tone of communication from Malleable became less constructive." Now, considering what they were willing to write in the public blog post, willing to do things like banning entire countries over a bad experience with a consultant from one company, I would not be surprised to know that some of the private discussion is less constructive. And considering some of the private discussions that have been leaked from customers of Malleable, that doesn't surprise me whatsoever. And considering the emails that I have been shared, again, not at all surprising that maybe they were not constructive, we'll say, in the very nice way to put it. "Despite these difficulties, we remain committed to resolving the situation professionally, Ultimately, we undid the changes made to the hardware, we returned it to Malleable, and ended the engagement without charging for any work performed. We parted ways on professional terms with no strings attached. Once again, they did not have a formal contract, so it's the nice thing to do to go and take the hardware and just put it back in the state that you received it, and since no money was exchanged, just give them back the hardware. We're done here. We regret that this project did not yield the desired outcome for either party. However, we firmly believe that our team acted with professionalism and integrity throughout the process. While we are open to constructive feedback, we were surprised by the tone and non-technical accusations in the blog post, as they do not reflect the nature of our engagement. One of the examples from the blog post is the person they had working on the project, Max. They were claiming, Malleable was claiming, that because they were not in the office 8 hours a day, they weren't doing full-time work. This person works half-time at home, half-time in the office. That's a totally normal thing to do in the tech industry. Also, they were only very recently out of college, 2 years out of college, and they claimed this person had very little experience working on Core Boot, but in reality, they're an experienced Core Boot developer, but they hadn't worked Core Boot jobs before, and they'd only recently gone through higher education, but they knew what they were doing in the project. At Nine Elements, we have successfully collaborated with many clients on complex technical projects. If Malleable was unable to find a single vendor to fulfill their needs, it may be worth considering if the challenges lie elsewhere. This is possibly the only snarky mark in the entire post. Now, considering what Malleable was willing to say about them, look, I think you deserve a couple of free shots here, and something this tame, I think I can just ignore. Now, that was Nine Elements. Let's go over to Core Boot. This, I don't understand how this made it as the official response from Core Boot, but I genuinely love it. Recently, there was a blog post by Malleable, a disgruntled laptop vendor who attempted to port Core Boot to their rebranded white label laptop. That's a very, like, true statement, right? Their laptop is just a Tongfeng laptop, but, like, saying it like that, just already off to a great start. The cause of the kerfuffle they describe is that they failed in their own attempt to port Core Boot to their laptop, then approached a few of our consultants and community members claiming the code was 80%+ complete, that they just needed help with debugging. Honestly, I don't even know, like, where to begin with this opening statement. Like, so many of these words are just, like, completely not needed, but, like, considering they were willing to chew out a ton of their consultants and developers, hey, again, you get some free punches. Each attempt was terminated in the evaluation phase. However, as the consultants and vendor disagreed on the amount of remaining effort and the supplied hardware had problems, flash read and write problems, UART access barely possible, which could not be resolved easily. Every single person involved in touching this hardware had these problems. If every single consultant has these problems, and along with an additional developer, either one of two things is possible. One, everybody in the Core Boot project is completely incompetent and has no idea what they're doing, which sort of leads me to believe that the Core Boot project wouldn't be in as good of a state as it's in, so that doesn't seem very likely. The second thing is there was legitimate hardware issues, and every developer here was running into those issues. This was not the first time that any of them had worked with clients. Like, they have done Core Boot porting in the past. Like, they know what they're doing when it comes to Core Boot porting. I don't believe for a second that they didn't know what they were doing. And going and saying, well, oh, we don't understand this, and then, like, annoying the customer enough so they leave, like, that's not a good business strategy, right? Like, if they just annoy the customer and they don't pay the money, then they're not going to make money, right? Like, they're a business. Like, there's clearly something actually wrong that all of them had a problem with. Additionally, this person's attitude and communication style was, to put it mildly, very off-putting. We've already gone into this. Feel free to watch the entire 40-minute video going over, we'll just, actually, you know what? Just read the Matt D'Avilia section, the Mr. Chromebox section, and you will just, that by itself, understand what's being said here. Just completely misunderstanding every interaction that's going on, interpreting everything that Matt is doing in the worst way possible, and again, no contracts were signed for work to be completed, no money was exchanged. Okay, this is actually really sad. So, they went and updated this segment of the post. Now, I don't have an archive of it. I didn't think they would go and remove it, but let me just read to you what it originally said. We won't do a point-by-point rebuttal of their screed since others have already refuted it in various forums, such as in this Reddit thread and this YouTube video. Now, the Reddit thread they were originally linking to was this one here posted by Malleable to the r/Linux forums, and the YouTube video they originally linked, and this is why I'm sad. I have made they originally linked to my YouTube video in the official response from Coreboot. And along with that, it said, there were several places where this vendor linked to their blog, and for obvious reasons, they got severely ratioed. I'm so sad that line got removed. It's such a good line. Come on, what are you doing? Like, I know it's not a great, like, official business response. Sure, whatever, but like, people already know that the line was posted now. Anyway, back to what it says now. However, it is important to emphasize that aside from NDAs, which are common for new product development, no contracts or statements of work were signed, and no money changed hands. Any suggestion from this vendor's blog that a Coreboot consultant failed to deliver on work they were hired or paid to do is false and defamatory. Our consultants have a strong track record of delivering for their customers on a variety of platforms, including embedded systems, laptops and desktops, networking equipment, and servers. They're also very friendly and will be happy to help scope out your next product needing simple, fast, and secure firmware. Honestly, I'm kind of surprised that Malleable gave up so quickly because they didn't go through every single one of the consultants. There's still a couple here they could have contacted that they wouldn't get a different response from, but it would have certainly made the blog post they made just a bit longer, and maybe that video would have been over an hour long. Now, I don't want it to be over an hour long, but it could have happened. Anyway, I hope this is the last that we ever hear about Malleable. There's still a possibility I do a video about the way they interact with people sometimes, because, yeah, that's kind of fun. We'll wait and see what happens there. Also, I'm still expecting to see Australia get banned. They have not been banned from Malleable yet, so what's going on? You gotta hurry up and ban me. Or ban my entire country. Anyway, yeah, the Malleable situation is certainly something, and it was a ride, that's for sure. That's gonna be it for me. So, if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video, and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LiberaPay, linked in the description down below. That's gonna be it for me, and I didn't write anything on board today, did I? Whatever. It is what it is. What is